We have discussed the type of lubricant and application of the lubricant. Now we will discuss the classification of the lubricants. Okay, so lubricant, I just told you, can be classified in 1 minute. There is a call. Hello. हाँ बोलिए. Can I talk to you later? Yes, ma'am. कुछ अर्जेंट है बताइए. हाँ ठीक. ओके ओके. कॉल फ्रॉम अननोन नंबर. ओके. So if you are able to, then we will continue. Like we are discussing about the classification of the lubricant. Okay. So classification generally lubricant according to the matter state can be categorized into three main category: liquid lubricants, mineral oils, petroleum oil, vegetable oils, semi-solid lubricants, solid lubricants. Okay. Semi-solid means that your petroleum jelly. ठीक है. मिनरल ऑयल्स, पेट्रोलियम ऑयल, वेजिटेबल ऑयल्स लिक्विड में आते हैं. सॉलिड में आते हैं आपके ग्रेफाइट, मोलिब्डेनम, डाइसल्फाइड एटसेट्रा. ओके, सो वी हैव कैटेगराइज्ड दीज लुब्रिकेंट बिकॉज द टाइप ऑफ एप्लीकेशन. वन लुब्रिकेंट टाइप हियर इज मिसिंग, दैट इज द गैस लुब्रिकेंट और एयर एज ए लुब्रिकेंट. दे आर सम बियरिंग दैट एरोडायनेमिक बियरिंग, एरोस्टेटिक बियरिंग, वेयर वी यूज द एयर एज ए लुब्रिकेंट. ओके, generally we do not classify those special category of the lubricant because air is freely available and air works as a lubricant. Okay, so like you here you are seeing the classification why we use liquid lubricants, why we use the semi solid lubricant, why we use the solid lubricants, what is the specific application, why where we use the graphite, where we use the petroleum jelly, where we will use the mineral oil. So all different kind of application depend on the Sommerfeld number. Okay, later we will study how the Sommerfeld number affect the study. So from the property, पहले जैसे मैं बताना चाहूँ कि why lubricant, ठीक है? So lubricant, so we are using the lubricant. So following property we are required from the lubricant, like property viscosity. First we require the viscosity. Second we require the emulsification number. Third precipitation number. Fourth neutralization number. 5 saponification value, 6 flash and fire point, 7 cloud and pour point. Okay, so there are the 7 specific property of the lubricant. First, viscosity, that is very important property. Second, emulsification number. Precipitation number, how it is important, let's see. So viscosity is very important. Okay, so fundamental application of lubricant, it depends on the viscosity. So second is the lubricity also. Lubricity is ability to lubricant, ability to lubricate moving parts and reduce friction. This property known as lubricity. Biodiesel is popular diesel fuel additive provide additional lubricity. So lubricity means it is stickiness towards a moving surface and reduce the property. Reduce the friction, known as lubricity. Biodiesel is a popular diesel fuel additive providing additional lubricity. Go to the next, come to the purpose of lubricant. So like we have discussed now the purpose of lubricant. So as I have discussed, the lubricant do not only reduce the friction, it has various other functions also. Keep moving part apart, that is fundamental, reduce friction. And another purpose of lubricant is the transfer heat. Okay, as I told you, in the gearbox or in the engine, so the very large load is separated by with the help of direct lubricant contact. Okay, so means the heat is completed, that is generated due to the friction, is carried away by lubricant. So fundamental, that is the property of the lubricant, it transfers the heat. So fourth is the carry away contaminants and debris. So it carry away the contaminants and debris also. It transmit the power. Okay, so it protect against the wear. Okay, so lubricant property like it transmit the power, it protects against the wear, prevent corrosion, seal for gases, stop the risk of smoke and fire of the object. Like you will see that in the icing here, there is no chance of danger, because whatever we are lubricant adding in the system, it should be smoke free and fire free. Okay, and further, it should stop the smoke and fire. So that's why lubricant generally do not burn. Okay, so it's carry away contaminants and debris. If that there is a friction, okay, there is a due to friction, there is a wear and tear. So lubricant has a property of soap. That's so it carry away the contaminants and debris. It transmit the power, protect against the wear. It protect against the wear and prevent the corrosion. So now come to the lubricant application. So one of the largest user of the lubricant is the automotive industry worldwide. One of the single largest application of the lubricant in the form of motor oil is protecting the internal combustion engine in motor vehicles. Okay, so that is the fundamental application, and lubricant such as two cycle, if you go to the market, so lubricant generally characterized 2T, 4T, two cycle oil. Okay, here you will see that two stock oil, okay, two cycle oil, 2T oil. So if you will see the most of the application of the lubricant is in IC engine. There are various other application of the lubricant also, that is in the area of in hydropower plant, hydroelectric power plant. So there are the various application also. Application of lubricant is everywhere. But when we go for the commercial level and when we see the marketing level, so there is the more importance of the lubricant in our IC engines, internal combustion engine. So lubricant generally comes 2T, 3T, 4T. Okay, so is an engine oil intended to use in two stroke are added to fuels like gasoline, which has low viscosity, low lubricity. Sulfur impurity in fuel also provides some lubrication property, which has to be taken in account when switching to a low sulfur diesel. So automotive, the engine oils, petrol engine oils, diesel engine oils, automatic transmission fluid, gearbox fluid, brake fluid, hydraulic fluid. So when we characterize that, so we characterize the lubrication into from basically four categories: automotive, so engine oil, petrol, gasoline engine oil, diesel oil, or automatic transmission oil. So whatever we have to do, like the property, like we have discussed here. So sometimes we require high pressure additive, like for the gearbox. Okay, we have to use a separate lubricant. Okay, so according to that and need, so we use the different oil. So like engine oil, petrol, engine oil, okay, automatic transmission fluids also come, and gearbox fluids are different, brake fluids are again different, and hydraulic fluids are different. So they are the different category of the fluids. So gearbox fluid, brake fluids, and hydraulic fluids, these are the different category of the fluids that we use in our engine. So brake fluid also works as lubricant, but they have different property, and hydraulic fluids are also again. So tractor, like there is a tractor, there is one lubricant for all system. In the tractor, we use the universal tractor transmission oil, UTTO, super tractor oil universal, STO, include engine, other motor two-stroke engine oil. So these are the different category of oil we use. Okay, so other motors are the two-stroke engine oil, so that we use. So there is some industrial application of like aviation application, hydraulic oils, air compressor oil, gas compressor oils, gears oil, bearing and circulating system oil, refrigerator compressor oils, steam and gas turbine oil. Okay, so these are some industrial application of the lubricant, like hydraulic oil, air compressor oil, gas compressor oil, gear oils, bearing and circulating system oils. Okay, these are some industrial application where we use. Okay, so and one more thing, that here the lubricant specific is always different. Like if we are using the gas compressor, okay, so if it is a reciprocating compressor, we have also used the lubricant there in refrigerator. Okay, but speed is quite low. Okay, so we have to use the thick viscous oil there, and another is the gear oils. So we here gear oils are also thick viscous oil, and fourth one is the bearing and circulating system oils. So bearing and circulating system oils we use. Okay, refrigerating compressor oils we use steam and gas turbine oil. So aviation application like gas turbine engine oils, piston engine oils. Okay, so marine application cross head cylinder oils, cross head crankcase oil, trunk piston engine oil, stern tube lubricant. So lubricant example now comes. These are some application that we have discussed. Okay, so now come to the example. So lubricant, generally lubricant can be anything that reduce the friction. That is the general definition. Okay, that is the fundamental definition, but lubricant can be anything like Lincoln oil, water. Like I have told you the example, like aapka jo air hai, that is also in the category of the lubricant. Okay, gas is also work as a lubricant. Okay, but application is different. So like if we have a machine, so we have to certainly find out some applications of the lubricant, and according to that we have to use. Okay, so type of the, according to the type of application we have to use the lubricant. So natural water repellent lanolin is derived from the sheep wool grease and is an alternative to more common petrochemical based lubricant. So this lubricant is also a corrosion inhibitor, protective against the rust, salt and acid. So water can be used on its own or as a major component in combustion with one of the either base oil commonly used in engineering process such as milling, lathe and turning. So when it comes to the reduce the friction as a cutting oil, water is also used as a lubricant. So a lanolin that is derived from the sheep wool grease and is alternative to the more common petrochemical based lubricant. Okay. The type of the lubricant, lubricants are characterized on several criteria. Generally lubricants are based on one type of base oil, or the it is quite possible to mixture of the lubricants. Okay, so whatever we do, we add additives in the base oil. So base oil are generally derived from the vegetable, generally derived from the nature. Okay, we add. The other one is a synthetic lubricant and solid lubricant. So if you have visited a bike repairing shop, so what is it? Yes, have you seen the lubricants there at the bike repairing shop? So आपसे कभी किसने पूछा व्हाट इज द सिंथेटिक, क्या आपकी गाड़ी में सिंथेटिक लुब्रिकेंट डालना है या बेस ऑयल डालना है, क्या डालना है, किस तरीके से डालना है? बहुत चीज आती है मार्केटिंग में, बेस ऑयल, सिंथेटिक ऑयल. ठीक है, एनीबडी? Anybody, what is the base oil? So okay, so base oil kya hote hai, when we do not add additive, okay, in the system. So generally that is base oil. Base oil have performance at base oil generally designed for the given temperature range. Vegetable oil also work for natural diet and it also work in the given range. Third one is the synthetic lubricant. What we do, we add some additive in the system. And those additive works. Okay, those additive works in the system, they improve the performance of base oil. They increase, they decrease the friction in the system. Okay, and similarly the synthetic lubricant. Synthetic lubricant, they are very good in the performance. Like for at cold level. Okay, at the hills, at the minus 30 degrees Celsius, you have to use the vehicle. Then we use the synthetic lubricant. So it will not freeze, okay, and at the up to plus 60-70 degrees Celsius, we can use the synthetic lubricant. Fourth one category is the solid lubricant. Okay, solid lubricant, that is a different type of category that we have, solid lubricant. Okay, what is the use of this solid lubricant? Okay, hum log iska kya karte hain? When we have almost zero speed, then we prefer the solid lubricant. Like I have given you the example of the base, example of the space lubricant. Like most of the cases in the space, we prefer the solid lubricant. But that also have some problem, like solid lubricant do not reduce the friction up to a certain level. So scientists are working to drive some lubricant that can work at about zero bar pressure and at extreme condition. In the space, conditions are extreme. So generally we nowadays we are using the synthetic lubricant, and in some bot case we are using the solid lubricant. Okay, where the moving parts are there, but still people are working to drive some lubricant for space application. So base oil, like this is the example of paraffin. Okay, so most lubricant use the mineral oil base stock made from crude oil. Each source of crude oil has its unique composition or combination of the compound, resulting in a wide range of characteristics as well as an appearance. Various crude oil have different colors and odors and have a variety of viscosity as well as properties. So these are also classified into three categories: paraffinic, naphthalenic, and aromatic. So basically these base oils, when we are doing the oil extraction, crude oil from the refinery, so we get the base oil. It has the high sulfur content and it has a variety of viscosity. Like ISO VG42, VG32, like if you have heard Servo 32, Servo 42, so 32 and 42 are their viscosity index. 46 also come, Servo 40 also come. So they are the viscosity index that is made by the Indian Oil they used to sell, and you have also seen those advertisement in the TV. Okay, so they are the base oil, so they are very good, and they are the characterized the high hydrocarbon. Naphthalenic, aromatic. So vegetable oils and other naturally derived lubricants. So these are the primary triglycerin extracted from the plant and animals. From the lubricant base oil, use the vegetable derived material. Materials are preferred. Common ones include high oleic, canola oil, castor oil, palm oil, sunflower seed oil, and rape seed oil from vegetables. And tall oil from animal sources. So many vegetables oil are often hydrolyzed to yield the acid, which are subsequently combined selectively to form specialist synthetic ester. Other normal derived lubricant include lanolin, wool, grease, a natural water repellent. Okay, so these are some vegetable oils. So they come from the nature, or they are not derived. Base oil are the derived from the crude oil. They are directly derived from the tree or plant or animal. So these are the called the vegetable oils or other naturally derived lubricants. Okay, so lanolin is one of the example. It is a water lubricant and with grease also. So synthetic lubricant continue to gain market share. Okay, so as I told you, it is a $1 billion industry in synthetic lubricant. So every company used to sell, they spend lot of dollars and money to sell the lubricants. There are various companies sell similar, Exxon Mobil, they used to manufacture these lubricants. Okay, so these are the company that used to manufacture the lubricant. So synthetic oil is lubricant consisting of chemical compounds which is artificially made, synthesized. Okay, so using the chemically modified petroleum component rather than whole crude oil, but also be synthesized from the using raw material. Okay, so synthetic basically they are used for high performance. Like I have given you the example, if a jet engine works at a ground where the temperature is 27 degrees Celsius and pressure is 1 bar, then it go to the atmosphere at 800 meter above or 8 kilometer above from the ground level. Okay. So it gets the lubricant inside the plane cools down, it absorb the heat. Okay. So synthetic lubricant continue to gain because due to the higher performance that for many use trump higher per drum cost. So demand in the year in the United States has grown to $2.2 billion per year and is a resulting benefit of stricter environment and worker safety requirements. So there are some typical example of the synthetic lubricant, polyolefin, synthetic ester, polyalkyne glycols, phosphate ester, alkylated naphthalene, silicate ester, and ionic fluids. So advantage of the synthetic lubricant are following: majorly better low, high temperature viscosity performance, better chemical and CH stability, improved the fuel economy in certain engine configuration, better lubrication on cold start, longer engine life. So synthetic lubricant, like we have discussed that application range, like they can work up to minus 50 degrees Celsius to 200 means minus 50 degrees Celsius to plus 50 degrees Celsius, and performance do not affected by the pressure. So like if you go to the market, so jab aap lubricant bharwane jayenge apni gaadi mein, if you will discuss the manufacturer, sir, if you discuss the mechanic, okay, so which kind of lubricant you are adding, generally he will prefer the to add a synthetic lubricant. Yes, synthetic lubricant is required when the pressure, okay, when your car has to work at different temperature level, like you are going to Ladakh and you have to work Ahmedabad where temperature 40 degrees Celsius in Ahmedabad, and in Ladakh it have about minus 10 degrees Celsius. So variation of the temperature about 50 degrees Celsius, and there we have to use the synthetic lubricant. But if you are traveling from Ahmedabad to Mumbai and your zone of travel in Gujarat, then you need not to change the lubricant, and base oil works better in that case. Okay. ठीक है, इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी रिगार्डिंग दिस प्लीज लेट मी नो. यस, एंड सिंथेटिक लुब्रिकेंट आर मोर केमिकल स्टेबल देन एज कंपेयर टू अदर लुब्रिकेंट. ओके, यस, एनी क्वेरी? Any query, please. ठीक है, rest we will discuss in next class. Thank you very much.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I will share my slides also with you on WhatsApp. I will share. Okay.